God wants us to finish what He has put on our hearts. The first and foremost thing that I want to share with us about finishing something that we have started is to desire to finish well. So aim to finish. And aim to finish, it's very difficult to go through an entire journey. When we consider life, life is a marathon, and so is our journey of faith. We need endurance to go through this entire journey and to reach the finish line. Hebrews chapter 12, you know, there we read about life being a race. The Greek word race is agona, which means there's some amount of struggle involved. There is conflict involved in this race or this journey of life that we are undertaking. And in this journey of life, you know, the sooner we understand that we are here for the long term and it's not a short sprint, it gives us the opportunity to plan well, to desire to finish well. The second key for us to finish strong is to build strength. Now, completing any race requires energy, it requires time, and it requires a lot of stamina. And the longer the race, the more the stamina that is required. For us to prepare ourselves for this journey of life, which is actually a marathon, you know, we have to build strength and a lot of stamina to do what God is calling us to do. The third key that will help us keep running this race is to commit to the vision. Now, God is a God of plan. He's a God of design. God has a dream for your life and for my life. And God puts that dream in our hearts and He wants us to run after that. And we have to get a hold of that vision. Where there is no revelation, where there's no vision, when we don't have a goal, when we're not looking at the end result, it's very easy to quit. So get a hold of the vision, developing consistency. So in our lives, we end up becoming what we do often or what we do regularly. So consistency plays a key role in staying in the race. The next point for us to keep running this race and finishing well is called endure. For things to come to fruition, you know, it takes time. And once again, you know, there is a need to endure. It's only when we endure that we will reach the finish line. When we're going through difficult seasons, the temptation sometimes is for us to say that I cannot do this anymore. But quitting brings a loss. Okay, if we can just endure for another step, we will get closer to the point of reward. There is a reward on the other side of the finish line. So don't quit. There are rewards for finishing and finishing well. So don't forfeit the prize by quitting, but endure. Stay firm and steadfast. Now, after having stood in the fight, after having run in the race, you know, what we are really required to do is to stand some more and run some more, because the journey may feel really, really long. Faith is essential for us to stand firm and to keep moving forward till the finish line. God strengthens us. So in this race, the beautiful thing is that we are not alone. We don't have to do it alone. The Holy Spirit of God, He's on the inside of us. The anointing of God teaches us all things, Scripture says, and God strengthens us in this journey. So fix your eyes on the Lord Jesus. Hope keeps us afloat. So as we are journeying to fulfill the call of God, the assignment of God for our lives, now let's keep hope afloat. Hope is a choice, right? Hope is a choice, and we have to focus on God. We have to focus on the result of our labor, which is glory to the name of God. And as we do that, hope is maintained in our hearts and we are able to run till the finish line. So how to keep this hope alive? Always remember who we are running for. Some of the things that we go through, they are momentary afflictions in the light of eternity. And this will keep our hope alive. Even if we're feeling weary, you know, it's okay to pause, but get back up and stay in the race and finish the race